Snow White expresses, more perfectly than any other fairy tale, the idea of melancholy. Its pure picture is the queen, who gazes into the snow through the window and wishes for her daughter in terms of the lifeless, animated beauty of the snowflakes, the black sorrow of the window frame, the stab of bleeding, and then dying in childbirth. The happy ending takes away nothing from this. As the wished-for granting is really death, the salvation remains appearance. For the deeper perception does not believe that she, who lies like someone sleeping in a glass coffin, was awakened. Isn't the poison bite of apple, dislodged from her throat by the bumpiness of the journey, rather than a means of murder, the remainder of the unrealized, exiled life from which one now she recovers, since no deceiving emissaries lure her anymore? And how frail sounds the happy end. Then Snow White found him good and went with him. How it is repelled by the wicked triumph over wickedness. Then when we hope for salvation, a voice says to us that hope is in vain, and yet it is above all this hope, powerless, alone, which permits us to draw another breath. All contemplation can do no more than patiently delineate the ambiguity of melancholy in ever new figures and approaches. The truth is not to be separated from the delusion that one day, out of the figures of appearance, there would nevertheless be salvation.